So can you correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe every match from now on out will be a best of five.
Yep.
That is perfect. So these contestants basically, they already made it to top 8. So people are already paid out. This is basically a 10 euro money match right now. Oh boy, the projectile being hit back. Ooh, what?
Oh, he went all in. He went a bit too far.
We hate and love to see it. You respect the attempt, but if you miss, you just look like a goofball. Oh, it takes it right back. Oh my god, this is all these scouts games so far.
Yeah.
Oh, what a conversion there. Oh, that's a big chunk. And with a read.
He went for it. Didn't work out too well. He doesn't have any bullets now. Let's find some hits.
Oh, yeah, the definitely not. Oh, was that a sliding tilt while switching? I've never seen someone do a sliding tilt with Afigalu. Like, you know, when you rush and you tilt, you keep sliding, and it seemed like he swapped on the slide then and it worked out.
He might have, I didn't realize. Maybe it was just down tilt, you know? That's a slide.
maybe. Either way, that's something I didn't even consider just yet. Oh, the uppie missing the tech trees there. Oh, he's gonna trying to save the totem, but then doesn't offer it, but gets punished coming back.
Yeah, just after the totem's death, so he had already lost his cells. It's really bad. But he gets his stock right back.
At least Gano, really even though he lost the stock early on, it looks like it's fairly even still, bringing it back. Oh, the back hitting for whopping 7 on the last hit there. Oh, he's just so ready, he's everywhere at the same time. Oh, as well as Pika did earlier, Ragnar trying to go for the beast. Oh no! He just jumped into that! He was charging the entire time, he rushed in there.
Yeah, not what you want to do.
Definitely not.
No, it's not looking too good for Ragnar, he's in the grab loops. It's not loops anymore,
yeah,
so
it was just a hit. But it was a strong hit.
Yeah, it's still a lot of damage.
Oh, oh, can he come back? Barely.
Yeah.
Oh, where's this Gano going? I guess teleporting back on stage and then obviously taking
right,
his
friend. Oh, doesn't care about his opponent.
Nobody left behind. Oh my goodness, how do you even fight that? Arachne has to come up. It's so... Oh, between both bullets.
Oh, and he barely dodges the up tilt. And you see the bullet didn't hit the charging Afi, that's... yeah.
Oops.
That's weird.
Oh, no, yeah, he did not up air because he double jumped. He was not quite committing to the super hop up air. Oh, the wicked back air, not quite enough. Oh, keeps it safe, pushes him off.
Oh, wow. This blaster is safe.
Oh my goodness. Your BS blaster is red.
Oh, yeah.
This could. Oh, red burst
out! Oh, that's
what
it,
a conversion!
Yeah.
I've never seen that!
Yeah, it's just. Wins. Guarantees the kill.
I don't see many Afigalus utilize the red burst, so this is kind of hype to see.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. 1-0 already for Liscano.
Yeah. On a good map for Reimer, so it's gonna be really tough for Arachno. Liscano has been popping up so much this tournament.
Yeah, there's definitely a lack of matchup experience for Arachno. Afingalo is very tricky, especially as a beginner. So let's see if he can adapt. What stage will he pick? I will just guess a random massive one, like something like Malu Malu, Cyber Scout, maybe not Cyber.
No, he really wants... Oh, what?
Does he pick Malu Malu? Did I call it?
He picked a small stage.
Oh, Shadowbriar it is?
Yeah.
I didn't think about Shadowbriar for this matchup. I don't know why, it just did not feel right for me. Like with the Afi chain swaps and then the platforms in the way as well. Maybe it helps. It might actually be good.
Might be decent because of the platforms getting in the way and everything. I guess he realizes big stages might not be the best against Liscano because Liscano is so good at approaching, uses his totem to take all the space and everything, you get pushed to the sides all the time. It's on a small stage, maybe it will be more close quarters.
Yeah, and now with the new...
But it's gonna be tough.
Oh yeah, now especially with the new Raymo, where you wanna be a bit more close than utilize your projectiles too much, since now there's more counterplay. Also in chat, hashtag catcam, indeed, cat super cute. Alright, we're going into game number two. I love that she's also enjoying the commentary. Just staying there, whatever she experiences, she appreciates it.
I mean, she's deaf, so she doesn't.
It's gonna be like a massage chair. Okay, now here we are though on the tiny stage, which is kind of surprising to me. I expected the opposite for Rotten to pick.
Yeah. It's also Rain Peak or something, it's probably banned though, but still. Yeah.
Oh, misses the aerial there. Oh my goodness. Oh, still punishes it. But only gets like a single hit. He needs like conversions that are bigger than that.
Yeah, I feel like this matchup is really tough right now.
Oh, curse already!
Yeah.
Oh, good back error. Nice spacing on the rush away, but now so percent. Let's see if we can make something happen. Oh no, the high recovery! And this gun reacting to it just grabs it.
Yeah, I know, just stand there on shield and you get crapped. I've been there against this guy though.
Yeah, it looks like there's just no way to run, he's everywhere at the same time.
Basically. I mean, he's
oh, the charge was just enough!
Oh, wow.
What a charge! That was a great charge, actually. I haven't seen him utilize it that much, but then... Raymo up there definitely needs a tiny charge to kill sometimes.
Yeah, maybe the DI wasn't perfect too.
Interesting option there, and calls him out. Whoa, the down tilt actually getting clipped out of it on the starting frames.
Yeah, it was, must have been the last frames of the startup. Okay, slides. The conversion. Just burst out.
Oh my goodness, the bullets were beat like that. I even thought the explosions of the bullets would hit, like without the bullets itself. Oh, this.
Maybe the explosion.
Oh, oh my goodness, punishes the totem big time, that's how it goes.
Yeah.
One thing to note, Raymo players can get bullets against the totem. So you can just jab the totem for the BS blaster. Maybe that's like a trick that we could pay attention to. Alright, that was difficult to avoid being below him.
Slamming the totem on the ground is such a strong option, especially on small stages.
Down tilt up air, up air barely not in time.
The lighter gallop touches the AP.
Oh, still has the tackle there.
Man, this hitbox stays there for so long inside me. Oh yeah.
Now, watching this counter play, it looks very much like what I said earlier about Seth being the one flying around most might not even be right. He's kind of just flying everywhere, throwing himself into the action. Alright, not the best recovery with the wall jump and then not having the rush ready for the ledge.
But the problem with Shadow Prayer, you can't like...
Yeah, it's difficult to wall jump.
Okay.
Forward air pushing a bit too far on shield and gets punished on the forward tilt attempt. Again, high recovery getting punished. Not a true punish, but Araku is just not opting to shield. Oh, this could be it! Forcing the burst.
Yeah, it's not
this looks like over.
It is, wow. The movement with the neutral B repulsive.
Very clean showing Baliscano. 2-0 in the lead. It looked like an even match for a while. They went down to 3 stocks and both on orange 40 HP, but... Holding on the pressure, Liscano doesn't let go and Arachna just didn't get the conversions he needed.
Yeah, it's tough. It's a tough matchup. Arachna is really good. Liscano, I mean.
And he's so consistent as well. He's consistently doing everything that you expect from an Afi.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. he has a lot of mix-ups, a lot of usage of all of his moves, all of his setups. It's super tough.
Now I wonder what the counterpack will be. I don't expect him to try Shadowbriar again, but maybe I might be mistaken.
Iodi and Tudo should wait for us. I didn't tell them, but yeah.
Did they start?
Played the first match.
Yeah, then I guess they should just play it through. It's your call, you're the TO here. Like usually what TOs sometimes do is they say, yeah, that doesn't count then until it's on stream, because we can't verify.
Oh,
but
no, it counts.
Yeah, it definitely should count if they gentleman it.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to sabotage anyone else. It sounds kind of grimy sometimes. Like I heard it before. Some TO options are just not what you like to hear.
The question is, do we stop them or do we...
That is your decision to make. That is all in your power, my man.
Yeah, I'll try to stop them, but we'll see.
Alright, now game number 3. Ariody in chat, do we stop us?
Stop us.
Do we? We do be doing.
Yeah, stop, please.
Yeah, you should be on the big screen.
Alright. Alright, next game on Forbidden Shrine, an interesting pick.
Oh, Forbidden Shrine. Some people hate this map, they despise it. Because of the high platform making it such a different deal than other stages. Personally, I think it's an interesting dynamic for some matchups.
Yeah, definitely, but it's so frustrating when you play a character that's used to like up tilt through the platform like I do all the time on every stage that has platform.
Oh yeah, so exactly. Cool. That's why it's so interesting, because you gotta come up with something else and sometimes.
Yeah, but I'm like, oh, he's on the platform, I'm gonna up tilt, and it's just like nope.
And some moves look like they almost hit, like I believe Erdos up tilt can't go through whatsoever.
Yeah, and Izzy is the same. It looks like he should go through, but it doesn't.
Oh, a bit of lag? What is going on?
Lag or control it's like lag. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess we restart this match. Sometimes this does happen. It's still an early alpha and some contestants have not the best internet. We still wanna get all the matches on stream if possible. Obviously, sometimes they can't handle the spectators. Very rare occasions. This game usually runs on every machine.
Yeah. Shiny. Yeah.
But game number 3, Liskano, yes. Very much a respectful gentleman of a player, allowing it, as we saw earlier against Piker, just letting him take his time. And if there is any like memory leak for Ragnar, I hope he can like restart his game as well, because contestants should be able to perform on the game and not experience any major issues. If you're ready, start the game.
Yep. Right.
It wasn't deep into the match, so we're all fine. Nothing major happened.
Just a false start, nothing too serious.
Alright, Arachno confirming in chat, game is good right now. Alright, game number 3. Liskano being up 2-0. This is possibly the tournament stock for Arachno right here. And since I mentioned earlier, there is a tiny rivalry between Arachno and Tudo.
Oh, what? Okay, my game is bugged. I can't see anything.
Oh, I might be able to stream it for you on the Discord. I actually don't know if I can. This might mess up a bunch of things. I hope this works. Alright. Oh, the up air takes it and a clean stock 0 to death. Down tilt, drill doesn't work. The charge hits the totem, hits the swap one. Missing option there.
Yeah, Liskano already up a full stock. Ragno needs to find those hits, those confirms.
The forward tilt spike! So I heard hints about the spike possibly being buffed, so in some future update that combo could have been the optimal one. Oh, still juggling, doesn't even look at his opponent, but just hits his totem.
He's fighting his friend, he's just parrying.
Oh, what a burst button, it's looking super clean there.
Oh, set up with the orb, it was a trade of projectiles.
Oh, what a snipe! With a bounce as well.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, the lingering hitbox on him, and he presses a button, not the right one, and gets punished.
Damn. Don't get into the kill. Alright.
Oh, keeps it safe. Forward tilts him off. Oh my goodness, dive super deep.
That's doesn't roll
something high. Too much. Oh, the homie stuck. At least kind of respecting the attempt and then keeping it even.
So nice. Yeah, just
I mean,
like
some
that.
People hate it. I can respect being up 2-0. You like to see it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's a nice gesture. I guess some people see it as a PM or something, but like 90% of the time, it's not.
Unless you had 1 HP and you homie stuck when somebody has these on 150, yeah. That definitely is BM. I mean, debatable, but still, we take it. Alright, but now he's kinda just trying to end his stock and getting the lead himself. Triple bullet kick into, just chases him, stage spike. Downer getting
really
beat by the uppie.
What?
Another bullet kick here, the downer on the ledge. Oh, he's kinda getting the follow up. So many just totems. It looks like there's more than two on the screen at a time in the midst of those combos. Forward air.
Oh, he gets it
again. No! Okay, he got hit. I think he is dead anyways, but he's gone just for the extra push. Oh, stocks to one, and we have another desync. Is that a forfeit? What is going on? It looks like this counter is fine. Arachnid is just having some technical issues for what it seems.
Yeah, I might restart my game in case it's on my hand.
I don't think so. This counter is working fine. What is happening, Arachnid? I hope there's a reason.
So for me, it's very fun because